Hello.
Hey, what's up?
What is happening?
Well, this is weird.
What's going on?
What do we do?
I don't... Well, I mean, we have to wait.
I think we give him 45 seconds and then we just call it.
Call? What does that mean, call it? Like, don't do the episode? What does call it mean?
Do we have another episode in the can?
No.
No.
Well, then we gotta go.
Yeah, we have to.
We don't have a choice.
Nick isn't here also. There's no Andrew. I don't really understand what's going on.
I feel like we might need Andrew.
I would say at the very least,
oh,
yes.
There we go. All right, you ready?
I'm on time.
Well, there's no way he's ready and recording.
I'm already recording. Go.
All right.
That tone is not... Oh, whatever. Just start.
Hello and welcome to another episode of the KFace podcast. I believe this is the 203rd iteration of this carnival of stupidity and cum we call a podcast. My name is Geoff Ramsey. With me, as always, Andrew Panton and Gavin Free. How's everybody doing?
Pretty good.
Fantastic.
Why on earth were you late?
I was on time. What do you mean?
You were.
Because one. It was one when I was here.
That's fair. You were within the 60-second grace period.
Why I was within the 60-second grace period.
Why on earth were you on time?
Better question.
Why was I early? I had to use the bathroom, and it was a bigger ordeal than I was anticipating.
So you traded pleasantries for what I assume was a liquid shit.
No. Oh. I thought I just had to pee, and there was more. It was a combo, and I thought I was getting an individual item, and it took more time than I anticipated.
So were you panic wiping? There's no way you've done a good job.
No, I was thorough. The job was done clean. But yeah, I was definitely... Actually, I had a slow-mo guy's TikTok running, and I was like, I got four more rotations of Gavin before... I gotta go. I gotta hurry.
Well, I appreciate the views.
You're welcome. Yeah, I just listen. It's going to be my algorithm.
Have you ever filmed somebody shitting with a phantom camera, Gavin?
No. Well, it's not that fast, unless you've really got...
It'd still be interesting to see in slow motion, wouldn't it?
No.
Maybe, no, don't do a human. Maybe do like a dog. Then it would feel more scientific.
Why did... Before you finished asking the question, why did Andrew answer?
If somebody is asking to the group, have you filmed someone shitting? I think it's important to declare no. It doesn't matter if it was aimed at you or not. I want it to be clear. No. I have not.
Yeah, but I was asking Gavin.
Yeah, but listen.
I'm not really a scat boy.
No, but you're into science, and fecal matter is just science at the end of the day.
That is true.
What isn't science?
Exactly.
I'd say Garfield. Garfield is science. Yes.
Science of Garfield. How do you feel?
I feel great.
Because last time you felt great but sounded like shit. This time you sound even worse.
I think I sound better. I disagree. I think I sound better than I did.
You do not.
You sound older. You sound 10 plus years.
You sound like you've seen some shit.
Well, I have, but I haven't filmed it.
You saw it at normal speed, unfortunately.
I did. I saw it at normal speed. I think my vocal cords are recovering, and I think yelling a lot, screaming when they were bad to show my enthusiasm, maybe wasn't a great idea. Maybe kind of delayed my overall recovery. So,
there was a lot of yelling in general, and especially towards Eric last week.
See, I don't even remember that.
Yeah, it was very rude.
You had five more words left in the podcast and you used four.
I got to save one for later. You never know when you need a word.
Great.
Okay.
Hey, do we know where Nick is or no?
He's dead. Well, okay. Oh, okay. He's sick.
All right.
He's not dead, but he's sick.
Ah.
Is that how you lead that up? He's dead. He's at the doctor.
He's through. the death doctor. He's at the mortician.
That was actually part of the reason why I was worried about getting here on time is because I told him I would make sure Craig was here. So I was like, I got to get Craig in. They can't start without Craig. I made a promise to Nick.
I did it before you got here. I mean, I did
Which
it.
Is great. Yeah, but he asked me to. So I felt a specific obligation.
Do we ever explain what Craig is? I feel like we talk about Craig.
I think we have, yeah.
Okay. So Discord recorder thing.
If not, just Google Craig.
And now we have a game.
Yeah, now we've explained it twice.
Let's do it every 100 episodes, to be safe.
Hey, let me ask you guys a question that came to me last night. We were actually, three of us were hanging out together last night. I won't say which three. We were at a baseball game, and I was watching some birds fly over the field and cast shadows, and that got me thinking, how come birds don't have visible balls? Like a boy bird, how come, like Albert, his ball's dropped, and his little balls swing every time he walks. Wouldn't it be funny if birds had balls, and like when they dove, the balls hung behind them and like fluttered in the air, and then when they slam on the brakes, the balls shoot forward? Like, how come birds don't have, wouldn't it be cooler if birds had balls, like visible balls?
I assume
balls?
With birds evolving to be as aerodynamic as possible,
yeah,
you wouldn't
say.
Want balls spinning and slapping in the wind.
Dude, I agree, but wouldn't it be fucking awesome? It would make birds so much more interesting.
Those are two separate conversations. I don't think evolution factors in what would be hilarious.
Yeah,
unfortunately,
fuck evolution. Evolution made a platypus. Should. How does that make sense? I want balls on my birds.
I love the idea of a bird flying up to something and then doing the thing where it like holds its wings up for drag so it can stop, and then the ball's just swinging around and it just does a backflip because it can't stop on time.
And then, like, think about it. Like, if you're a snake or like a small rodent, and a big bird grabs you and it takes you up into the air, and it's like fucking dunzo, dude, that it's over for you. You have one last defense. If you can get to the balls, I bet it'll drop you.
I feel like it'd also be a problem with the birds that land on water, because fish would constantly be nibbling.
Oh, yeah, can you imagine?
The balls would land before the bird does.
Yeah.
Not even nibbling, but you know how like fish will jump out of the water, like going in for a fish and then just getting whacked in the balls over and over again as all the other fish are just coming up.
Just like a low pass and your nuts just get obliterated.
It would be the worst if you were like a nearsighted bird with big balls just constantly smacking into shit.
Do you think it would be too cruel to craft a very small rubber set of testicles and give them to a bird to wear, just to see what the aerodynamics would be?
That's science.
That's sort of...
Well, we do know a bird expert. I feel like we could run this by them and maybe see.
You know what? I'm going to Google it. Do birds have balls?
They're internal.
I'm sure they're internal.
It has external balls. Birds, like, there's got to be, like, one now.
I mean, think about skydiving with no pants. And that's what you're positing.
That's exactly what I'm thinking of. That would be that's what I want to see. Every time I see a bird, I want to see a dude skydiving with no pants on.
I feel like there are some birds that can go faster than like human terminal velocity. If you had like a falcon with a set of balls, they might just get ripped off.
Could a bird castrate itself?
Could a bird outfly its testicles?
You get the bird gets snapped by the bungee cord, but the balls keep going and make a tsunami in the water below.
It's times like this that I wish I was an artist. I'd love to be able to draw a falcon with a big old pair of hairy balls.
Do you think when a bird gets back to the nest, it's just nuts out? It's just laying down, popping the balls out.
It's like Al Bundy. It's just a...
I saw the most amazing animal dick the other day on a video. Can you guess which animal kingdom penis I was looking at?
Do you want to give us a multiple choice? I mean,
yeah,
there's like
could,
a billion
could you give
animals.
Us a little bit? There's a lot. It's a wide range.
It was a barnacle.
A barnacle? Really?
Okay.
I've learned that a barnacle is a little creature, and it swims its head into a rock or something, and then it builds a little shell around itself, and it might be like, I don't know, a centimeter in length. But its penis is 8 times its body length. So you have a load of barnacles all sat on a rock, and then during mating, they're all shooting their penises out and dipping their cocks in all the other nearby barnacles. And they're all just like sharing. There might be a bit of 3-on-1. It's the craziest shit I've ever seen in my life. And those are some long, I think it's the longest penis in the animal kingdom in relation to its body length.
Really? So are there boy barnacles and girl barnacles then?
No, they're all hermaphrodites.
Okay.
The ones I was watching. So it doesn't really matter where they land.
It's just like a soggy cock orgy down there.
Yeah. It was tremendous. There's nothing freakier than just nature on planet Earth.
This guy's got so many dicks. Look at this dick face.
Oh, just God.
Just dicking about. Cocks everywhere. We don't even know it. I don't know his character name from Pirates of the Caribbean, but that's immediately where my brain went.
Do you think he just walks into a cave for mating season because it's too embarrassing to talk to people?
Oh, no. I don't want to imagine. That's why you got to buy the DVDs. It's a deleted scene. That's on the unrated. That's the director's cut. Mating season with that guy. What's his name? He was in Thor. That guy's in a million things.
Oh.
I don't have the slightest
Skarsgård.
Idea. Yeah. There you go. Good pull.
Thank you.
Speaking of pull, I got a photo.
Let's see it.
Ooh.
Unrelated. This is a callback. As we know, we're talking, Gavin, you were talking about some potential joke thievery in the past.
Ooh.
And I like to settle things. I like to make sure everything's cleared up. So I went and I did my due diligence and I found the tweet and then immediately closed the case. Not great. I don't think Jack saw that. 9 likes, 1 quote, 5 reposts.
So you think the chances are slim?
I think they were very slim. It didn't get a lot of attention.
What?
But I mean, they worked in the same office. Oh, no, not in November, though. Not in November.
That would have been after my first stint. So that doesn't show views, though.
No, but it, I mean...
No, that's true.
I don't know. 9 likes is pretty rough.
Sorry that my tweet wasn't very good back in 2009.
No, I'm not saying... I'm just saying as far as, like, I don't think that went around. I think the algorithm didn't help that tweet, is my argument.
Did people like tweets that much, though, back then?
I feel like...
Are you proposing that Jack would have liked the tweet?
I think that the likes reflect how many people see the tweet. And the fact that I think I'm one of the 9 that have liked it does not help the case that this was visible at any time. I had to search it on your profile.
I think that just lends itself to the idea that Jack felt comfortable stealing it because he knew not a lot of people had seen it.
100%. I don't know what Andrew's trying to prove here. It feels like it proved the inverse, right?
It's also, that's a pretty slow-mo tweet, so I wasn't known.
You've damned Jack. As a matter of fact, Jack is probably one of the only people who could have seen it back then because nobody knew or liked Gavin back
100%.
Then.
I think Andrew's proving it to be true. Also, have you checked the date? Was that, in fact, before the podcast?
I was having a hard time aligning your version of the podcast with, because I did look in there as well. I don't think what you said was exactly accurate.
Oh,
the timeline didn't come up when I listened.
It didn't come up. Where am I getting it from?
I don't know. I think you may have misremembered when it happened.
If the podcast came out before this tweet, then that means Gavin stole it from Jack.
Yeah.
Oh, that would be a twist.
Well, see, now you're excited to find it.
I gotta go.
Suddenly he's reinvigorated. Yeah.
I like how quickly Gavin agreed with that. He just went, yeah, I must have stolen it then. Absolutely.
Speaking of lab, I have 2 lab things I want to get to today at some point.
Okay.
Ooh.
But we don't have to do it right now. Should we talk about the baseball game last night? That was pretty fun.
Yeah, go ahead.
Dollar hot dog night.
Talk about the fact that you're too sick to record a Let's Play, but good enough to go to Dollar Hot Dog Night.
Continue. Dude, I wouldn't say I was good enough, but I was definitely better at the end of the day than I was at the beginning of the day. I was on the mend, as it were. I went out of town with Millie over the weekend to go visit a college, and I got sick on like Monday. And then by last night, I was mostly better, but I just like, I got real sick all at once, but only for like 36 hours. And I think I just must be because I'm run down from, I don't know, all the tragedy and trauma of losing my career and whatnot. I think I'm just running on empty. But I was still sick enough that I couldn't eat my hot dogs. I was only able
okay.
To
well,
eat
then, yeah, never mind. Take back what I said. You're sick.
Yeah. It was pretty ill. I barely had any cotton candy.
We've been hanging out quite a lot recently.
We have. It's been nice. I've enjoyed it. You not so much. But I've enjoyed everybody else. I enjoy Meg a lot. You're just there, usually. But that's okay. I'm used. I gotta be honest with you. It's been a long friendship. I'm kind of over it.
I mean, can't argue that.
No, I'm kidding. I've had a lot of fun lately. Whose idea was the baseball games? Was that Eric?
I believe it was mine.
Oh,
thank you for right. scheduling.
Yeah, you know what? Yeah, never mind. It's Andrew.
Yeah, I sent you all a Google invite. It was great. Didn't you win something at the baseball game? I want to know about you winning something. What did you win?
What did I win? I got a at the third inning they do like trivia, and they asked if I wanted to do trivia, and I was like, absolutely not. And then Emily and Eric were like, yes, he does. And I was like, I really don't. And the guy goes, you're Geoff? And I was like, ah, fuck. And I was like, yeah. And he goes, all right, you're definitely doing it. And then I was like, Gavin's here too. I tried to throw Gavin under the bus. And he's like, cool, we'll mic him up too. And then when they came by, Gavin conveniently went to the bathroom, which was very smart of him. And I had to do Whataburger trivia.
Oh, so were you in a spontaneous ad for Whataburger?
Yeah, I just was suddenly, they were like, they asked me the question, like, what is the one animal that is allowed to go through the Whataburger drive-thru? And it was like, horse, bull, or llama. And so clearly it's horse. We live in Texas. And so I said horse. And then they were like, wrong, it's bull. And I was like, are you fucking kidding me? And then they were like, April Fools, it is actually horse. We don't know why the card is wrong.
And, this was yesterday?
This was last night, yeah.
April 10th, the classic day of April Fools.
Yeah, April Fools plus nine.
It was just an arrow, was it?
I think so, yeah.
Oh, okay.
And they gave me a bag with a Whataburger koozie, so I'm fucking set.
We also hung out for the Eclipse, and
oh, yeah.
We saw little glimpses of totality through quite a lot of cloud, and everyone was, you know, taking pictures and stuff, and I thought, when I was looking at the thing, I want to get a picture, but how would the British Jackal take the picture? So I got this little bag. That is the moon.
It's exactly
in front of the sun.
That's fantastic. It's exactly how Graysie would take that picture. It's really good. It's classic British Jackal.
Right.
That's awesome.
Right. Graysie, did you get any pictures of it? Did you see it?
Yeah, I'm actually, I mean, y'all know I have trouble with this. I'm trying to get my photos on the computer so I can send them to y'all.
Are you my mom? What's going on?
I don't know why the photos don't go well.
I'm trying to get photos on my computer.
Oh, it worked.
Yes!
Whoa, that's really good.
That's cute.
Oh, that's great.
That's awesome.
She's blind, so it did. I guess the glasses didn't matter. But, you know,
it would be cool if the eclipse shocked her back to sight.
Oh, did the reverse?
Yeah.
I don't know that she could handle that. I think that might be the straw that would break the camel's back of Cinnamon. Cinnamon came in for a recording of another podcast not too long ago, and I've never seen a dog sundown in the middle of the day while pacing infinitely, would not stop at all. Cinnamon is in her own world.
Yeah,
perfect is what she is. Fuck,
that's what Arrow was like for the last year or so.
What's this one?
It's another hack. Dot hack.
That's a hack.
Oh, wow, look at that. You got a better view of it.
What if everybody
work?
Yeah, well, I had to download it and open it.
Oh, well, here you go.
Oh, wow.
That's like the diamond ring, they call it, or whatever. Well, it looks kind of like a ring. When there's a lot on one side, so it looks kind of like the shape of a ring.
Yeah.
Okay. Ah. What if the eclipse stole everyone who stared at it without glasses? It stole everyone's vision but one person, and then they got the power of everybody else's vision.
Right, they got super vision.
Yeah, like 20,000 vision.
So it's, I don't like think the I'd one, want that. But for eyesight?
I think that'd be a nightmare to have, like, yeah, the one's eyesight. If you could see everything, like see a speck of dust, just, I think you'd realize how dirty everything is. It would be terrible.
There was a comic book I read many years ago called Rising Stars, where everybody in this town that was fucking when a comet went over the town all got pregnant, and then they all had kids, and then those kids were all born with superpowers, and then every time one of those kids would die, like get hit by a car or something because they're young, everybody else's powers would increase. So then one of them became a serial killer and started killing them all, and they were all becoming more powerful, and then But so was the killer, and they were trying to figure out who it was that was killing them, and I never finished it.
Is that different to the Triffids thing?
Day of the Triffids? I never saw that or read it.
Doesn't that get everyone blind?
I don't know.
And then it's like plants.
I know of it, but I never saw it.
There's the movie Blindness where they all went blind for no reason. And then they got their sight back for no reason. Wasn't good. Wouldn't recommend it. I also took an Eclipse photo because I saw my social media feed was filled with everybody else taking photos. This was my contribution to the overall conversation. Look at this crazy eclipse. Oh my God. It's really the white cover and the silver.
Is that an Umidigi?
Yeah, that's my Umidigi Bison. Unfortunately not watermarked, or so you wouldn't have to ask.
Do you have a sprinkler?
I do, yeah.
Okay.
It terrifies me. You have made me terrified of sprinklers.
You've
made me so scared of them. You did that slow-mo video of how they work, and in my head, it's just like the most flimsy piece of glass just holding everything together, and I assume if I break one, they'll all go off somehow, and I'm terrified of them.
It's just like my video, except the water pressure in reality is like 5 times higher.
Oh, God. I don't know what I'd save. I don't know what I'd grab. I could grab
if
one.
If you're an achievement hunter, you wouldn't save anything, apparently. You'd just let it all soak.
God, I forgot about that.
Well, I didn't. Set that room back a year.
I have a Rooster Teeth question for you, Geoff.
I don't really work there anymore.
Yeah, I know. Well, you were there at one point. You were there.
I was.
Yeah, you may remember this. How did you make the mouse move in 1-800-MAGIC?
Oh my God.
How did I make the mouse move in 1-800?
The mouths.
Oh, yeah, the mouths move in 1-800-MAGIC. Crazy.
Yeah, do you work on 1-800-MAGIC at all?
I did, yeah. We used a program called Crazy Talk.
Oh, wow. Okay.
That did mouth movements. Yeah. We used it a lot in those early days. I think that was mostly I think Joel directed production, if memory serves. So he would have done the lion's share of it. I did a lot of the machinima, but yeah, Joel and Matt
really
did a lot of the Crazy Talk stuff. Yeah, you would just like, it was like pre-VTuber stuff, right? Real rudimentary and not great, but it was like one step up from those Conan O'Brien bits in the old days.
We watched episode 1, Eric and I, recently. I'm going to keep
hold
at
up.
It. So I was... it exists.
You can definitely watch it.
I genuinely don't remember anything about it. I don't even know if I'm in it.
You are. I think. I can't
I'm pretty
tell,
sure.
but I think you are.
I think your voice modulated.
Andrew found it on his Xbox 360 as he went through his previously downloaded material and re-downloaded it so we could watch it.
Oh, wow.
We're doing some videos, and at the end of every episode of the video, we're watching episode 1-800-MAGIC. We got 3 more to go, but
it's so fucking goofy, dude. It is. You can tell when it was made because it's attempting to be so cinematic, and you're like, huh? And what purpose does this serve? And it really is. Well, you know, to be cinematic, it's fucking great. It is so much fun to watch.
I remember that game being difficult to machinimate in. But the reality is fucking every single game other than Halo was difficult to machinimate in. That's why we only did a few series.
Yeah, it's one of the nice features about the 360 is you can view your entire downloaded history. And the 360 marketplace is closing in either June or July. So I went all the way down to the bottom yesterday. And I am just going through grabbing every weird thing I downloaded at the time, thinking it was good content or just fascinating. So like I have like 15 videos on E3 2007. I have wacky bloopers with Seth Green from when he did Mass Effect voiceover. I got Shia LaBeouf interviews. I got a lot of stuff for us to unpack eventually.
So what are you doing with it? How are you keeping it?
It's just on my 360. I'm downloading it to my hard drive on my 360.
Oh, I see. Oh,
yeah,
I might do that. That,
that is so cool. Yeah, I'm going to do that.
You should. It is a massive annoyance, but
it's so slow. going from menu to fucking menu is just like eating glass. It sucks, and you suffer through it so you can watch the first episode of 1-800-MAGIC. It's fucking crazy.
Some of it, though, is great because it's things I didn't even know existed, but I downloaded and played. So, for example, I got a Real Steel demo. I didn't know they made a video game of the movie Real Steel, and I have that.
What was
Real
Steel?
I don't
know
what it is. It was a Hugh Jackman action movie where
Rock'em,
like a kid controls
robots thing, right? Yeah.
That I think failed. I had no idea they made a game for it, but I guess I did because I downloaded it. Yeah, I have that demo. I'd like to do a video with everybody where it's just us going through weird stuff that I probably thought was cool when I was 14.
I think that's a great idea. I think I'd love to see all of our download files.
Well, so everybody has to get on it soon because that marketplace is going away. So it's like part of it also is just preservation stuff.
Yeah. I think they just turned off all the Wii U and 3DS stores too.
They did. It's sad. It is sad. It made me realize that there's probably stuff I wanted there. Because I realized I found a game called The Way of the Dog that I just didn't know existed. Like Snoop Dogg made a 360 arcade game that he is prevalent in that I've never heard anybody talk about or seen any gameplay for. It was during his Snoop Lion phase. It looks insane. So
Andrew showed it to me and I thought that that's what we were gonna play. And then we didn't. So what was this? Why did you trick me? Why did I get tricked? And he's like, oh, I thought I made it really clear that like we weren't playing this. And it's like, well, this is the only thing you showed me.
I open with, we're not playing it, but I just learned this thing exists and I need to show you this because I've never seen this. I didn't know this.
We recorded like the first 10 minutes of this fucking other gameplay that is just us looking at stuff for Way of the Dog. And then we didn't play it.
We'll get there. We'll eventually get there. I got very excited because I have the Expendables 2 game demo and it is so bad. The voice acting is so hilariously terrible. And it's one of my, you can't buy it anymore. I just have access to it because of the demo. And apparently Eric bought it. So we might do
I'm
a
looking
deeper
into
dive.
It. I have this game. I'm pretty, I just had to like look it up. I have Expendables 2. I've beaten it a bunch of times.
We should make a point with the new thing of playing the most terrible video games that are on
there.
We have to like really hunt to track down like that. I think that's a great idea.
Like Ratey Boy?
Yeah, exactly. Expendables 2 and Ratey Boy.
As an example, yes, Ratey Boy. As a thing in practice, no, Ratey Boy. Exactly.
Right. I had an idea for when we get jobs at the mall.
Oh, yeah?
Okay.
Because, you know, we're going to have free time. We could do it.
Yeah, absolutely.
But I think what we should all do first is go through some quite heavy makeup to mimic what the undercover boss does so that when we apply for a job, they'll definitely give us the job because they'll think we're the undercover boss. So I'm thinking like taped on beard, some sort of wig and a cap just to make us look slightly out of place.
So we're going to impersonate undercover boss impersonating an employee.
Exactly.
I love this.
Just to give us the edge. And it will probably 100%. Keep people off our back and it will keep people friendly to us.
I like it.
This is a brilliant idea, Gavin.
We should just secretly keep having like what look like serious calls in the corner. And they'll be like, oh, sorry, I'm back.
And just constantly be like writing stuff down in a notebook. Like furrowing your brow and going,
yeah, exactly.
Now I want to do undercover boss stuff. This, I'm looking at undercover boss makeup stuff. Some of these are so good.
So good.
These
all need to go through the undercover boss makeover. Maybe we can employ some of the people from the show. I want to know what I would look like if I was a CEO working retail.
These are great.
Do you think they get any like control over what the outfits look like? Because we're looking at a guy with like brown hair and they put him in a blonde wig and gave him blonde facial hair, plain shirt.
Oh, that's the least convincing makeup I've ever seen.
It's a guy with like very clean cut and then like the shaggiest.
We all gotta do this.
Yeah.
I'm so you sent me down a fucking rabbit hole. This rocks.
The Yankee Candle guy is amazing.
Oh man.
We just need a group photo of all of us as undercover bosses, I think.
What?
I think it'd be a sick poster.
What the fuck? What? I found
some of them are borderline offensive.
Sanders.
That's awesome.
The thing with that show that I thought was always so funny is the notion that a person working at Yankee Candle in the mall would just know what the CEO looks like. Like, that's such a ridiculous assumption. That is such a self, like, ego thing of like, well, of course they'll recognize me. I gotta be disguised.
The manager might.
I don't know about that, but I can. I don't think I can name. If I go into a mall, I bet you I don't know what the CEO looks like of any of those places.
Dude, I worked at Sydney's Fried Chicken in high school. They had 3 stores in the area where I grew up, and I couldn't have told you what the owner of those stores looked like to save my life. No fucking clue.
Ridiculous.
That dude never showed his face in my Sydney's Fried Chicken in Theodore.
Deion Sanders is like the exception of like, yeah, it makes sense. You need to...
Why did we never dress up Matt and give him a job in Achievement Hunter? That would have been class.
That actually would have been a funny idea to see if you could have convinced the other people that this is not somebody they work with. Be like, yeah, hey, this is a streamer coming in. See how they do.
Is this the point where I admit to everybody that Jeremy Dooley was actually Matt Hullum in disguise?
Oh my God. We never saw them together.
We got too deep into it and we didn't know how to get out. So we had to move him to Boston. It's the only way we could end the bit.
I never saw them together. It's
of course
so
not.
Fucking funny. It's by virtue of Matt not being there. Yeah, I've never seen them together.
Matt Hullum had to walk around on his knees for 3 fucking years. He's sick of it by the end.
It is a great like qualifier because, as Eric's saying, it means nothing. I've never seen John Adams and Albert Einstein together. That doesn't mean they're the same person, but I like that. Just applying that to anyone. Big Show and Brad Pitt, never seen them together. Can't rule it out. Don't know.
Eric and Andrew, never seen them together.
It's true.
That's your fault, because we have been together, even though Eric doesn't know it.
What?
Oh, probably like a PAX
or like
something.
I went to PAX and you were like, we interacted
got
before.
It. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. So I agree. That's Gavin's fault. Yeah.
Yeah, it is.
Hey, I want to give you guys opinion on something. This is one of my, it's a minor lab thing. But y'all know how I'm recording all of my farts so that I can release my audiobook 1001 Farts.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Which I'm making great progress with, by the way. I woke up the other night at like 3:30 in the morning and just had a burst of creativity. got like 7 or 8 good ones out. But, while I was recording my farts, or while I've been recording my farts, I've been thinking of other things to record.
Well, you're already in the middle of recording 1,001 gallons of piss. You're just doing that simultaneously.
Well, yeah, that's what I was going to say is, should I be recording all of my pees?
No.
No, hold on. Hold on. Let's see where I'm going. What if, Andrew, you recorded yourself peeing? What would it sound like? It would sound like you peeing, right? Or it would sound like the beginning of Goonies when they're trying to figure out how to get down to the basement. It would just sound like a person pissing. But what if you layered 100 of your pees on top of each other? Would it sound like Niagara Falls? Would it sound like the piss version of roaring waterfall? And if so, would that be the first ever piss waterfall in existence? Wouldn't we be breaking new ground? New sonic ground?
Do you think if you record 1,000 people whispering, it sounds like people yelling?
No, I think it sounds like 1,000 people whispering.
Yeah.
It'd be pretty loud, though. I think, I don't know, Gav, I don't know what happens when I record myself peeing 100 times and lay it all on top of each other, but it might sound really fucking cool, so I think we should find out. So I haven't started yet, but as of today, I'm going to start recording all of my pees.
If I found out that the waterfall sound that I fall asleep to is just a dude's pee 100 times over, I would be so mad.
I would be outraged.
I can't wait, Geoff, for you to have that finished file, because we could just overlay it on footage of Niagara Falls and see how out of place it
sounds. We have to upload it as an ASMR video.
I was about to say, we did the most amazing, like, gentle, get your, like, fall asleep, like, to, like, natural earth sounds, but it's all pee and poo-poo stuff. And people just don't know it.
You know what? This is a perfect audio game for the listeners, too, because we can maybe, like, record some actual water sounds and then put yours in and see if anyone can tell the difference.
What, like a guess the piss sort of thing?
Yeah, well, like, if Geoff does his waterfall piss thing, if we get some audio of real waterfalls and then be like, which of these three are Geoff's piss, to see if anyone can figure it out.
I think everyone will figure it out.
Well, I don't think so.
I don't know. That's like, I want to do that. I want to do a game called Who Farted, where we all record a fart just for it, and then we mix it up, and we put it in jumbled order, and then everybody has to take the test to see if they can correctly identify all the farts, including their own.
I'm going to have to get my CPAP out again.
I meant to ask you that, because you mentioned passingly, recently you're on the CPAP again. Did you ever solve that problem?
Or are
you just living with it? Oh, no. Oh, no.
I'm off it again. I just get a gun full of air. I need it turned down, but they lock you out of all the settings.
That's so funny.
You need the person who charges $80 to change a setting on it to do it.
We're talking about a lot of things we might get into. Did you guys see the email TPG sent us this week?
I haven't had a chance to look at it yet, but I saw that he sent a video.
Was it good?
Yes, it is so good.
I'll have to watch it.
Let me post a link to it. Give me a second. One of my favorite things at TPG is when he just sends us a random video about things. And this is specifically at us, as well as a talking point in general. So I'm going to post it. We can watch it. It's very short. It's only 53 seconds. And then we can talk about it. I also have to... the thing that I love about TPG is sometimes it's hard to tell how intentional some of the stuff is. Because he has the... his comedic timing in this is insanely funny. He nails it. So this is the video right now. You can load up a watch. It's called Future Hobbies.
It's black and white. Green Life.
It's black and white. Well, it's a serious video.
All right, I'm starting it now.
What's up, Face Team? It's your boy, TPG. I'm out here on another walk. I was thinking about one thing, and that's if you guys ever find yourself running from Future Hobbies.
Future Hobbies.
I feel like I see a lot of birds. And... I've recently been like, you know, I'd like to get deeper into that. But then I get afraid that birding is like an old man hobby, and then I don't do it. But I probably should. You guys ever have hobbies that you feel that you don't do because you associate them with that just like a later stage of life? I just think about that a lot, like fishing. I don't know if I want to be a fishing guy, but I like being outside. Quilting or sewing. I miss you guys. Hope you guys are doing well. Why am I running from my future hobby self? Should I get a kite?
Kills me.
Dude, I've been exactly where he is with the birding thing. I finally just embraced it. I've got a haiku box and everything. My yard records birds 24 hours a day. Get into it, TPG. It's awesome.
Are there any hobbies that you ran from outside of birding? Or is that the one where you're like, I don't know. I don't know about this. This
is an old man thing. I decided not to get back into comic books in my 40s. I thought about it briefly.
So the reverse.
I thought about it, and then I thought, no, I'm past this. I don't want to go back to this.
Interesting. Oh, what was yours, Graysie? Graysie said she also had the reverse.
Yeah, I saw this girl on TikTok who makes coloring books, and I was really tempted. But then I was like, I'm not 5 anymore.
You should make coloring books. What do you mean?
I think you should definitely make a coloring book, Graysie.
Oh my God, of course.
Can I tell you all a secret? I bought it anyway, and I do have it.
This is cheating at the game. This is so creepy. No way I'm getting into this. By the way, I have it.
Right. Well, wait. I mean, and you were talking about getting it potentially back into moon shoes at some point. So maybe you're just in an era of nostalgia.
Yeah, no, I think every day I get a little closer to reverting to my childhood self.
I feel like that's just what acting is. It's just like you're pretending. It's like when you're playing as a kid and making stuff up, it's the same thing, just on a larger scale. It's okay to revisit those.
Do you?
I don't think.
Do you have one, Andrew?
I'm trying to think of. I don't know if I have a passion that I was. I guess video games, but that's not necessarily a kid specific thing. Mm. I'm trying to think of like a through line. A lot of things I got in and out of. Hobbies I've avoided because I never even occurred to me the idea that an old man hobby represents that I'm getting closer to death. I have more things where I'm like, oh, I wonder when I started caring about this. Like I really want to get a recliner. Like I want a lazy boy at some point. I got really excited thinking like I haven't looked into that world at all. And I bet you there's some crazy tech in the lazy boy recliner. Oh, yeah.
I wonder what the most expensive lazy boy does.
You got to think it's like a massager.
While you're looking that up, Gav, I'll see if I can jog your memory. I remember back, this is a couple years ago. I almost think it was while we lived together. I think it was after we lived together. But I remember you were telling me that you always wanted to, you were like, I wouldn't say desperate to get into it, but you always were really intrigued by the idea of giving strange dudes hand jobs in like a public rest station. But you were scared to start. Is that the same thing? Do you guys think? Maybe?
What is it, 2012 again? Where did
that come from? Just thinking of hobbies that, you know, you're scared to, you want to do, but you're scared to do. And I remember that being
a big
thing.
Do you think
he
was afraid to start because he wouldn't be able to stop?
I think so.
Do you think
that's
where the fear came from?
Yeah.
Well, I think the stopping would be out of his control.
Yeah, I feel like that's on the other person.
I think you were afraid. I don't remember. I'd have to go back. I wish we'd recorded those conversations. I just remember you being really into the idea, but being scared that you'd get lost in it, I think is what
you're
you said.
You're an idiot.
Oh, man.
I was really intrigued there. I was like, oh, I wonder what I was trying to get into.
Oh, no.
And then it was hand jobs. I was like, oh.
Oh, it was a bit.
Son of a.
He got me again.
I thought I had another forgotten thing. Like my forgotten life hack.
Gotta keep you guessing.
Oh, Geoff, you said you had a new life hack.
Did I?
Yeah, when we were annoying Eric at the diner the other day.
Oh, are you talking about the my banana thing?
Oh, yeah. Was that not for face?
Yeah, the banana.
We already talked about it.
What was my life hack? I don't remember it.
I don't
know. The banana thing?
It is the banana thing. The banana thing. No, the banana thing is for face. That's it. Andrew, we've talked a lot about bananas in the past, right?
No, wait, no, time. Wait, time out. We've done the banana thing. We've talked about the banana.
What's the banana thing?
Isn't it about peels? Isn't it something to do with peels?
Absolutely
and
not.
Like, okay, so go ahead. Never mind.
All right.
You didn't even remember what it was? You just thought peels?
Well, I feel like banana, we talked about like... bananas recently, and I assumed it was one and the same.
No, it's absolutely not.
This is he's not annoyed in this picture, but he's miffed.
I can tell.
Allow me to blow your mind. Okay, y'all know how we've talked a lot about bananas in the past, how they're kind of a C-plus fruit at best. Nice thing about a banana is it's always about as good as a banana is. Very rarely is a banana bad, but the ceiling for a banana is just low. Like, there's no such thing as an A-plus banana. Okay. You've never had a banana and said that's an A-plus banana, but you've had a lot of...
I certainly haven't.
You've had a lot of C plus or maybe B minus bananas.
Sometimes a banana just hits the spot.
Good bananas, but they're never better than a banana. The ceiling for a banana is not an A tier fruit. And I like bananas.
I just don't like bananas.
But I figured out a way. I figured out a way to break the banana ceiling, Andrew.
Okay. Does it involve hand jobs and bathrooms?
No. This isn't. Okay. Get your head out of the gutter, man. Don't be Gavin in 2012. Okay.
I'll try.
Here's what I would like to invent. I'm going to invent a metal straw that's similar in shape to a banana. And then what we're going to do is we're going to start taking bananas. We're going to peel them, you know, about a third of the way down, as you would do when you're about to eat a banana. And then you take that metal straw and you stick it in the head of the banana and you take it all the way down through the center till about, I'd say 8/10 of the way down the banana, then pull it out. And what that's going to do is it's going to create a little hole through the center of the banana that runs all the way, almost all the way down, like a banana shaft, right? Then with that banana shaft, clean out the stick or get a different stick, insert it back in. And then through that stick, if you get a little funnel, if we need to, we can create a little banana funnel, pour in chocolate syrup or magic shell or caramel, and then take the straw out. And then when you eat a banana,
you've got a little bit of chocolate in you or a little bit of caramel in you, but it's in the middle of the banana, so it doesn't get on your hands. It doesn't get messy. It's self-contained. And if you want a frozen treat, stick it in the freezer for 15 minutes, and then you've got a crunchy chocolate center in the middle of your banana. Boom! We just flipped the banana world on its head.
It feels very infomercially what you're describing, and I support that. I don't like bananas.
Think about how it would taste.
It would taste amazing.
Yeah, I don't know. I just don't like bananas.
I think we could do this. We could do this week.
I think the banana shaft is an idea that's desperate to come to fruition. I really do. I think everybody's going to be blown away.
I'm a fan of the name Banana Shaft. That just sounds fun. That sounds like a good product.
Think banana about it. Shaft. Like, you've seen people try to plus up a banana, right? Like, they do it in Austin. You get, like, a frozen banana that's, like, dipped in chocolate or whatever. But that shit gets messy. It gets all over your hands. It's the same thing as, like, eating a drumstick or an ice cream cone. This, you get the structure of the banana, but all the flavors on the inside where it's not messy. And it's delivered perfectly to the inside of your mouth. Just enough. Just enough. Oh, I think it's going to be... I think it's going to... It might change the world.
Why isn't everything messy on the inside? Like, why is the icing on the cake not in the inside?
That's a great point, and maybe it should be, Gav. Maybe that's where we should be headed with this.
I think all goo should be internal.
kind of like when you eat gum and then it's got the little, like, or like a hard candy and it's got the gooey stuff in the center. Exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What about, where do you fall on barbecue, though? Like ribs. How you doing ribs?
If the sauce was in the ribs? Oh!
I don't know if I want that, honestly.
In Texas, we don't have sauce. Everything is dry rub, so we don't need it.
If the rub was in the ribs? Oh!
Now, an internal rib rub, that'd be interesting.
Well, Graysie said every time she eats a banana, she pukes. What's going on?
I don't know. I think I might be allergic, but I just avoid them now.
Can we have you eat one?
No!
and we'll just
Why would
time
I voluntarily
how long,
do that?
We'll just time how long you can keep it down.
Graysie, if you were to eat a banana, eat a banana-shafted banana, recognizing that you don't eat bananas, but if you were to eat a banana-shafted banana, would you rather it have a caramel filling, a chocolate filling, or like a magic shell frozen filling? What do you think would be the most appealing to you?
I mean, as a chocolate hater, caramel.
Caramel. Okay, so if I could shaft a banana full of caramel, do you think you'd give it a shot? It might fix bananas.
Give it a
shot. Okay.
But it would
hell
it
yeah.
be painful.
I'm all for her doing this for some reason, being backed into a corner. You proposed that by saying, recognizing you don't like bananas and you don't want to eat one. Are you this is pretty fucking cool.
What if you,
that was really great.
What if you caught out the banana and lined it with Pepto?
Oh!
Ew. And then it would settle your stomach on impact and then the banana would stay down.
Medicinal
or
banana.
What if we just stick a bunch of Tums in it?
Yeah, line it with Tum goo.
well, there's not really goo involved.
No,
in
you can mash crunch. It up.
They're very chalky.
Powder? I'll just bite into a banana powder in the middle.
Yeah, powder them up and then just get a bit of moisture and make a paste and then we'll put
roll it in the powder and give it like a coating.
But this is turning into something very different from the banana shaft. I'd just like to I'm totally on board with the medicinal Pepto banana. But
when it starts
involving dry materials, I think.
Well, the Pepto goes inside. The Tums go on the outside.
That's
well,
you probably right. OD on. You can't have
that's
Tums.
What,
and
I was
Pepto,
about to ask. Do you think if you grinded up Tums and snorted it, would it have the same effect? Can it only be chewed?
No. I think it.
No.
I think I'll try.
It would go into your blood, and it would probably work.
Next time I wake up with heartburn, I'm going to grind up some Tums and snort it. Solve the problem.
I think we should all go to the lab at some point over the weekend and try to create our own banana shaft.
We'll see what are we using? We need a uniform item to core it out that we can all get hold of.
I'm just going to use like either a straw or...
Yeah, how are you going to get around the corner?
I don't know. I just try to like straighten the banana. It's not going to be ideal, but you know, just make do with what you got. That's a part of it's going to, this is the process is like figuring it out, right? I have some straws like that.
Can I borrow one?
Yeah. Yeah, for sure.
Okay. I'll have to think about this.
That is the exact straw I was thinking of when I pitched this.
Yeah, because you can kind of go in and then give it like a little curve, you know?
Yeah.
Should we then all meet up and present our, why can't I say present? Present our bananas?
Yeah, I think that's a good idea.
I mean, we're not going to do it together. Yeah. We're going to do it independently and then bring bananas to each other? Opened bananas?
I'd rather we do it here so I can see what everyone does, or at
least
get a recap.
That makes sense. So we'll present them next Thursday. Anyway.
Okay. I want to be part of the experience, but that's, hey, if Gavin wants to box me out, that's fine.
No, wouldn't it be
British
like
jackals?
There's no banana box.
The British jackal trying to box me out again. It's fine.
You would be on camera. You'd be on a little laptop.
That's fine.
Well, we'll figure it out offline. We don't have to figure out the particulars.
The British jackal once again.
You mean Graysie?
No, Gracie's great. I have to come up with a new name for you. Let me think about it.
The people really took to Graysie becoming the British Jackal.
It's a great name.
Such a good name. And to go from Metal Snake, which was so strong, to British Jackal is unbelievable. I don't think anyone's had as good nicknames at this company.
No, to out of the gate with two just absolute bangers of nicknames. That's pretty impressive.
Yeah. They also really took to my picture of how full my bathtub was.
You took that picture like a fucking crazy person. Like, of course they were going to come at it.
Well, Gavin specifically said, put your arm in it, put your hand flat on the bottom so that we can see where the water hits on your arm. Yeah. And then everybody else was jumping to conclusions saying that I didn't want to put my feet on the internet, which I don't. But there was a reason I did it the way I did it.
I was just blown away that your head was in it, and you did it backwards.
The,
you did like a
selfie.
With like an aggressive...
I didn't know how else to get... Like, I wasn't going to do
a
selfie
of your
timer.
Arm and flick it to the wide lens or something?
Oh. Well,
that's what was the
that way.
Oh!
When you put it that way, I couldn't. But look what we got out of it.
Yeah. I mean, at no point was I mad. It was amazing.
No, it's great.
Like a psychopath.
I realized the audience had an extreme love for Graysie. We did a trivia tournament, and Graysie cheated during it and admitted that she had cheated and still failed. And I thought, people are going to be so outraged about this cheating. And all of the comments were, that game fucked Graysie. She used a lifeline, and it gave her the wrong answer. That's some bullshit.
We got some justice for Graysie going on.
There was justice for Graysie, but she cheated. She cheated the game. What do you mean?
The audience. We've got the best audience.
This, it makes no sense.
You can never predict. Yeah.
And the shark, there's one of the Graysie photo, but it's the shark is the backdrop. It's very
funny. Hey, I know I've already I know I've already pitched a whole piss thing. And then I pitched a banana shaft to you guys. But I have one other idea I'd like to throw away before the end of the episode. I think this is an opportunity for us to go viral, extremely viral. And I just want to throw it out there and see how you guys feel about it. I woke up the other night from a dead ass sleep with this idea, like 4 a.m. First thing that came to mind, I woke up and thought, how come you never see NBA stars holding pets? Like, think about it. Think about Shaq. Shaq's like 7 feet tall, but you've never seen him hold like a kitty cat. Or like Kristaps Porzingis is like 7'3", or Chet Holmgren, who's like 7'2". But you never see them like playing with a ferret or a bunny rabbit. They would look so comically small in their hands. Then it hit me. Victor Wembanyama, most promising star, future of the NBA, I don't think I Googled it. I don't think he's ever been photographed holding. Oh, see, that's perfect. Shaq and the cat is perfect. That's a full grown lion or a full grown tiger in Shaq's arms right there. See, what if we got Victor Wembanyama? We started a campaign to get Victor Wembanyama to hold a chihuahua in his hands, and we can call it hashtag WimbyWawa.
Oh.
Okay. Yeah. So thoughts, guys, go ahead.
I'm all for it. I heard some of this idea the other day. I wanted to get, my suggestion was Kevin Durant, and he would just hold an ant.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, that works well. I like Victor Wembanyama because he's close. He's just
he's close in Texas. There's a lot of chihuahuas in Texas. The chihuahua is the smallest dog. He's like the biggest dude, Wimby Wawa. He could just hold it in his hands and it would look like, it would look so comically tiny and it would be so cute. What's cuter than NBA stars with cute little pets? And then we just find pets that are appropriate for different NBA stars' names. And then we just start a social campaign. And before long, you know, the San Antonio Spurs are going to see it and they're going to go, listen, we are in last fucking place right now. Anything we can do to get eyes on the Spurs right now while we have this Wimby phenomenon. And then boom, there you go.
Well, my two immediate thoughts are, one, if there is ever a time to start a new series at Rooster Teeth, this certainly is it. It's great timing. Big fan of that. Also, I think it's very funny to pitch and film a video with Victor Wembanyama for a website that will not exist by the time it is done.
Well, maybe we don't start it until the new thing flips over. Maybe we hold off on our viral moment and for like a month.
Sure. Okay.
I just think we got to strike while the iron's hot. Season's almost over. They're not going to be in the playoffs. Although, it's an interesting way to get some eyes on the Spurs while all the other teams are playing in the playoffs and they're sitting at home. He'll have a lot of free time on his hands, and all he has to do is put a chihuahua in his hands, and then boom, the world will notice.
Should reach out and really make sure that he knows that you recently won a trivia thing at a baseball game. I think that'll really impress him.
Round Rock Express. And I've run out the San Antonio Brahmas, a local peer team to the San Antonio Spurs.
It's true. And there are multiple leagues now, right?
I'm like locally known in San Antonio sports parts.
As a sports game attendant.
I've attended multiple games in the San Antonio area.
Why is it attendee and not attendant?
Because the attendant is the person who takes the tickets.
Huh.
What makes an attendant super?
Yeah, why do other jobs not have super?
Like super producer? Eric, I think we should all agree that Eric should only be referred to as super producer from here on out.
I like that.
Thank you very much. I just found out superintendent is one word and not two words. That's pretty exciting. It is.
Yeah.
I thought I was looking up what a regular intendant was, and that's not it's just simply not a word. So I don't know if super producer really fits, but I'll take it. Thank you.
Why don't you take intendant?
I suppose I could. It's spelled different.
This is Eric. He's our intendant.
The administrator of an opera house or theater.
That's kind of kind of appropriate. This is kind of theater of the mind, if you will.
Yeah.
I won't.
If you will, I won't. I won't.
I'm excited. I get to record a bunch of pee and inject. We all get to inject caramel and chocolate into bananas, and we got to figure out a way to get a 7'5" tall man to hold a chihuahua. I feel like there's
now.
Future's pretty bright.
Before we wrap up, I just want to clarify for this: does it have to be a banana? Could it be another? Could it be a different product? If I have a different vision, but for the same idea, I'd rather do something. Okay.
I don't know that it would be considered a banana shaft if it's not a banana.
No, but you know, I think it's important to corner a market, like a hot dog, right?
Well, they've already done that with hot dogs and cheese. They've already done that. Cheese dogs are the fucking bomb.
Gracie's idea is to remove the hot dog from the corn dog. So
no!
You can just use the coating of the corn dog?
Yeah, like just so that good batter bread.
Instead of breadcrumbing an item, you want to use one from a hot dog, from a corn dog.
Like every once in a while, you get a hollow Whopper and it just like collapses on itself when you eat it.
What?
You know, Whoppers, those candies, Whoppers.
Oh, I thought you meant burgers.
No, I thought you meant from burger.
Yeah.
Whoppers, like malted milk balls, like those things. Every once in a while.
Yeah. I get it. I get it now. Inside. Yeah.
Yeah.
You know when you get a Big Mac and sometimes the buttons don't do up?
At least my thing was called a Whopper.
Yeah. It just is a much less known Whopper.
It depends on what part you're in, I guess. From what I hear, people don't like Burger King. I don't know anybody that doesn't like Whoppers. You don't like Whoppers?
Oh, you mean the candy and not the hamburger still. I understand. It's just confusing.
Eric,
this is why you have to refer to it. Well, no, I am. It just that part really got... This is why I referred to it as Sonic the Hedgehog and Sonic Burger. So it's like you can tell them apart. You know what I mean?
Everybody likes a Whopper candy.
See, that's great.
Are they like Maltesers?
Yes. Yeah, they are like Maltesers.
Yeah, same thing.
I wonder which one is better.
I don't like Maltesers.
No. I don't like Maltesers. I like Whoppers. Malted milk duds. Milk duds. Those are good. Or malted milk balls. Is that what they're called? There's another brand too.
What is malt?
What is malt?
It's the next rating after super. It goes super, then malt.
Malt intendant.
Oh, this is about to be a letdown. It is a cereal grain that has been made to germinate by soaking in water and then stopped from germination further by drying with hot air. Ew.
So it's like Blue Balls cereal?
Yeah, it's like it's like edged cereal.
It's edged cereal. It's been gooning like crazy, and now you have to eat it as candies in candy shape. That's all you. You got it.
Ugh.
All right, we need to wrap this up now on that note, I guess.
All right. Well, thanks for listening to another episode of the F-Face Podcast. This has been episode 203. We hope you had a good time. We sure enjoyed talking at you. And why don't you check back next week, because we'll be here and we'll be saying a bunch of other dumb shit. Until then, bye.
Bye.
Yeah, Andrew said no. No more.
My throat is sore. We don't need to all say bye at the end of every episode. You two both said it. It's fine.
Would have been easier bye. To say bye than have. No, it's too late now.
Bye.
See, that was so late. That's going to be on the beginning of next week's episode.
Hey guys, Major League fan Jack here with a look at next week's episode of F-Face. Of course, they aren't ahead in recording yet, so instead of guessing next week's episode, I'm going to guess what they said in this episode. Geoff mourned the loss of O.J. Simpson. Eric talks about how the cookbooks are in people's hands. Andrew remembers a recipe he meant to put in that cookbook. Gavin is confused about a legal matter. The British Jackal once again steals the spotlight. And once again, Andrew does not eat the pencil. All that and more was on this week's episode of F*** Face. Who knows what happens next week?